In the early 2000s, Palm had a problem. They had captured 80% of the personal digital assistant market, just as digital cameras and MP3 players were becoming popular, and Palm's easy-to-use operating system was an ideal platform to take advantage of increasing convergence of phones, cameras, and media players. The trend was clear. People wanted the devices in their pockets to do more. The problem was, Palm's devices were still using an old, slow CPU from the 1990s. It was called the Motorola Dragonball. The Dragonball was originally based on the Motorola 68000 CPU, originally released in 1979. The 68000 was used in the Commodore Amiga and the original Apple Macintoshes in the 1980s. In its day, these were amazing CPUs. By the mid-1990s, the 68000 had been developed into the low-power Dragonball, which was ideal for portable devices. But by the early 2000s, this CPU simply couldn't keep up the pace. The 33MHz Dragonball was not even powerful enough to play a simple MP3, and there was no upgrade path available. The Dragonball CPU in Palm PDAs had reached their limit. If their operating system was to continue, Palm needed to find a solution. Palm were facing a challenge. Not only did their own devices need to become more powerful, but they were licensing Palm OS to other manufacturers who were also being affected by the limits of the CPU. Sony was one of these manufacturers with their Clea range of PDAs. Sony's solution to this problem was to start adding custom support chips to be able to play MP3s and have higher resolution screens for better image quality. This worked well, but it made their devices internally more complex and power hungry and expensive. This was not a good long-term solution to the problem. Palm had only one option if they wanted to continue. They needed to transition their entire operating system, including support for the third-party apps that had been developed over the years, to a completely different CPU architecture, just as Apple is doing today, with their new Mac OS that runs on the M1 chip. And Microsoft are also trying this with Windows ARM, which I looked at in the previous video. Here is the Palm Tungsten T, Palm's first ARM-powered PDA, released in 2002. It's got a 144MHz Texas Instruments OMAP ARM CPU. I'll be comparing this to the previous model, the Palm M515, released earlier the same year. I reviewed the M515 in a previous video last year with mixed results. The M515 runs Palm OS 4, while the Tungsten T runs the ARM-based Palm OS 5. Palm wanted a seamless transition, so they wrote a full emulator to be able to run the previous Dragonball-based apps and make it completely transparent to the end user. The first main difference to the previous models is the slide that opens to reveal the stylus writing area. Even with the slide open, this unit feels extremely solid. The front navigation buttons now feature four-way buttons plus a center press, compared to just the up and down on the M515 and previous models. In the SD card slot, I have a 256MB card, which would have been the biggest capacity available at the time. Next to it sits the stylus, and when you press it, it pops up and easily comes out. Things start to get interesting on the left side, with a headphone socket, a button with play and record symbols, and a small hole hiding the microphone. The rear of the unit shows the Palm branding, and it also shows the Texas Instruments OMAP CPU branding as well. The operating system, while rewritten for the ARM CPU, looks surprisingly similar to the previous versions. The main difference when turning it on is you see the higher resolution 320 by 320 LCD, and there's a new built-in app called Voice Memo. Pressing the new side button does start the Voice Memo app, but to start recording and playback, only the on-screen controls work. The side button, with the play and record symbols, only functioned for starting the app. I would have thought this button would be more useful for starting the record function. And there are more odd things about this model. For example, despite having a Texas Instruments OMAP CPU, which stands for Open Multimedia Applications Platform, and a stereo headphone socket, there's no multimedia or even music player software included. Third-party MP3-capable software did appear shortly after release. However, Palm included a 4 kHz low-pass audio filter for the voice recording function, which they embedded directly into the operating system, with no option to turn it off. The filter is fine for the voice recorder, but it ruins the high-quality multimedia capabilities of the hardware. That means whatever software you use to play music always sounds muffled. It's unclear why Palm did this. So let's have a listen. I'm going to play an MP3 using AeroPlayer and record the output so we can have a listen. It really sounds quite low quality. Fortunately, after a few months, Palm listened to their customers and they released a software patch that disables the low-pass filter. Once installed and restarting the Palm, playing MP3s now sounds as you would expect, as decent quality music. The ARM CPU is also just fast enough to decode MP4 video as well. I have encoded a couple of test files here. The first one is 320 by 240 resolution video, and that's close to the native screen resolution, and it looks quite good, but the frame rate is quite jerky.
Here we go. This fella here is just like a bush lolly. All the kids love it. Well, not just the kids, I reckon it's pretty good too.
For the second test clip, the resolution is down to 216 by 116 pixels. It still looks good, and the frame rate is now much smoother. Yep, I'd watch that out in the bush.
Here in the Gulf Country, the wet hasn't yet arrived. It's hanging around the place, but it's not here in full swing yet.
Let's do a CPU comparison and run some benchmarking. On the previous model, with a 33 MHz Dragon Ball, the M515 runs a respectable 170% of the baseline Palm 5. On the 144 MHz Tungsten T, the same benchmark runs an astounding 278% above baseline. And remember, this benchmark software is running on the Dragon Ball emulation layer with no native ARM code. It's Dragon Ball CPU code being translated by the emulation layer to run on the ARM CPU. I do have a later version of this benchmark software with ARM code included that runs even faster at 312% of baseline, with the baseline now being set as the faster Palm 3C. But it's the CPU emulation layer that is most impressive here. According to Dimitri GR, a Palm enthusiast who's been porting Palm OS to new custom hardware, the emulation core consists of 60 kilobytes of handwritten ARM assembly instructions. And it's so stable that with later versions of Palm OS, there was no need to update the core emulation code. That is some seriously impressive work by Palm. I think I can forgive them for the audio filter problems at the start if this is what they were able to achieve. Even some of the built-in apps, such as the calculator, are the previous Dragon Ball versions running in emulated mode, because it all works so well. Now let's look at gaming. One of my favourite games is Zap 2000 and Zap 2016. Zap 2016 is the ARM enhanced version, and it plays extremely well as expected on the Palm Tungsten T. But I also have here the original Zap 2000, designed for Dragonball CPU based Palms. When running it on here, there is a warning screen at the start telling us this was designed for earlier Palm OS's. Yet, even though this is running on the emulation core, it plays fine. It's fast and responsive, with no slowdowns. This is the level of emulation compatibility that I would hope any company transitioning to ARM would strive to achieve. Not everything's going to run perfectly though. One of my favourite scene demos from Palm OS 4, called Plasma, that looks great on the M515, doesn't run properly on the Tungsten T. It looks like the emulation is good, but the way the demo is accessing the screen, using methods that are likely well outside of Palm's regular APIs. Scene demos often use tricks like this to get the most out of the hardware, and it looks like, in this case, the new Palm OS 5 isn't too happy. I'm really enjoying using this Palm model, and of course, I want to do more. There is Amiga emulation software that has been developed for Palm OS 5. I have tried to get it running on here, but so far I've been unable. There are later models of Palm PDAs that use the more powerful Intel X-Scale ARM CPU, which I am going to try out one day. They also have more memory, including heap memory, and this should help with Amiga emulation on later models. For now, I'll have to make do with this Amiga mod player, playing some of my favourite demo scene mod files, such as this Red Sector demo track by Romeo Knight, called Rise Up. Please help out the channel with any engagement that you can do. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and thanks for watching.